وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. We were in the مظاهر الدنو والهمة, the phenomenon of low aspiration. We mentioned three in our previous episodes, and inshallah ta'ala today we're going to take the fourth thing, or the fourth aspect that brings about low aspiration, and that is al-bukhl. Bukhl is stinginess. Bukhl comes about, or it's found, when a person becomes excessive in fearing poverty. Someone fears poverty, they fear hunger, and so they resort to being stingy. The more your khawf min al-faqri increases, then this character, this trait starts to come about. وَيَنْشَأُ, from there comes a tabi'a, a natural trait of the person, which is al-hirsu ala jam'i al-mal. You know, they start gathering their wealth and money, and the person then holds back from giving from the wealth. So they hold on to their wealth. حَتَّى يُمْسِكَ عَنِ الْإِنْفَاقِ فِي وُجُوهِ الْخَيْرِ. So the person withholds from giving in good. And whenever they're requested to give money, they start becoming agitated. And this trait, this characteristics of al-bukhl, really destroys high aspiration. And it brings about, in that person, low aspiration. Because remember when we defined high aspiration, we said that high aspiration, it brings good qualities, noble traits and attributes from you. And low aspiration, it brings the exact opposite of that. The person withholds from spending in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And subhanAllah, sometimes what happens is that the person withholds from giving in good, but he spends in his desires. وَيُطْلِقْهَا فِي إِتِبَاعِ الشَّهَوَاتِ. He gives it in following his desires. So then the two evil traits become present in him, which is al-bukhl wal-israf. He's stingy from one perspective. He's not giving the wealth in the cause of Allah and the religion and in khayr. And also he's doing israf, which is excessive usage. He's spending it on his desires and what his nafs, ma tashtahihi al-anfus, that which his nafs is desiring and wants. فالبخل دليل على سقوط الهمة. فالبخل دليل على سقوط الهمة. Bukhl is an evidence, a clear-cut proof that an individual's aspiration has dropped. And the amount of stinginess that's in you is the amount of low aspiration in you. وهو مخل بالدين, and it damages your religion. والمروءة, and your integrity and morality. And it brings about for a person harm in this world before the hereafter. The bakhil is ba'idun min Allah. He's far from Allah. Ba'idun min khalqillah. He's also far from the people. People, they don't want to be close to somebody like that. Somebody who would watch the people suffer and wouldn't do anything for them. The wealth you have was given to you by Allah Azza wa Jalla. Allah bestowed it upon you. He gave it to you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And your aspiration has become so low that you only want to fulfill yourself. And that is exactly the same quality that shaitan had, right? Which is ana. That's the first word he said when he was asked, why did you not prostrate to Adam? He said, qala ana, me. And that same quality is present in this person who's got the wealth. He says, me. he thinks of himself and doesn't look at what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded. So that person's aspiration is very low. They're not looking at the hereafter. They're not looking at what's going to wait for them on the other side. Our Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he entered onto our mother Aisha. And he said, Aisha, the meal that was brought to us today, the meat that was brought to us, what is left? And she said, O Messenger of Allah, we have nothing from the meat except a shoulder. And Aisha and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one of the things they used to do is that if food was brought to their house, they would share it with the neighbors and they would share it with the people in need. So he asked her, what is left from it? He thought that she gave it all out. And she said, O Messenger of Allah, all that is left now is the shoulder. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam corrected his wife. He said, Aisha, that is not the case. He corrected her. He said to her, everything else is here and the shoulder's gone. Ya'ani, the parts that we gave for the sake of Allah is actually ours. It's what we own. And this shoulder that's left for us, and we're going to eat, and then we're going to digest, is actually not ours. So that is what the Prophet was nurturing her upon, to stay away from al-bukhul. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he loves ma'ali al-umur wa yakrahu safsafaha. The Prophet loved high aspiration, and he doesn't like people who choose low aspiration. Al-bukhlu, the person who is bakhil. وَالْبَخِيلُ بَعِيدٌ مِنَ اللَّهِ, he's far from Allah, that person. بَعِيدٌ مِنْ خَلْقِ اللَّهِ, is far from the creation of Allah. بَعِيدٌ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ, and that person is far from Jannah. قَرِيبٌ مِنَ النَّارِ, and is close to the hellfire. The person who's stingy is ضَيُّقُ الصَّدْرِ, his heart is actually tight. And that person, مَمْنُوعٌ مِنَ الْإِنْشِرَاحِ, his heart is actually prevented from expanding. That person is actually saghirun nafs. If you sit with him, his personality, his mission in life, all of it seems very low, very small. Qalilul farah, you don't tend to find a bakhil always happy. He's always stressed and worried. Kathirul hammi wal gham, in state of distress, worry and thinking and because of the wealth or whatever he has. لا يكاد تقضى له حاجة, there is no matter in his life that he accomplishes except he's worried about the next. You will find the person who doesn't have much but gives is more happier than the one who has wealth but chooses not to give. Also, from the things that are al-bukhul is al-bukhul fil jah. A person is bakhil in his position. And he wants to be in charge. He only worries about, am I going to be given this position? I'm the only one who's entitled for this position. That is also a form of bukhul. It's a person who has low aspiration. وَلِذَٰلِكَ the Prophet ﷺ, he told, salawatullahi wa salamun alayhi, this matter, meaning leadership, is not given for the one who asks for it. You shouldn't want it for yourself. It should be chosen for you. Also, al-bukhlu fil jahi, which is having bukhl in your position, if you're not benefiting other people through your positioning. You, for example, have influence, and you're not benefiting the people in need. For example, the ruler of the country listens to you. He's willing to take anything from you. If you don't use that for the ones who are in need, get the aitam, the orphans taken care of, the aramil, the widowed women, or the divorced women, or the women who have no money and are in need, and you're not taking from the ruler funds to take care of those people, the tullab al-ilm, the students of knowledge, who are seeking knowledge but don't have much to eat. If you don't benefit the people with your position, this is al-bukhlu fil jah. There's another form of al-bukhlu is al-bukhlu fil ilm. That a person is bakhil in his knowledge. He learns and he keeps it to himself. He doesn't share it with the people. He doesn't benefit the community and the people around him. And a lot of people have al-bukhlu fil ilmi. They are stingy with the knowledge that they have in their own households. Their family are dwelling in sins and ma'asi, and he doesn't take time out to educate them and to teach them and benefit them. He's going out there, for example, teaching other people, whereas his own household is in need of it. Al-bukhlu fil ilm. It happens, it occurs. Also, al-bukhlu fi badli nushi. Some people are stingy when it comes to giving advice. They see a person who is plunged into sins, a person who's deep into sins, he doesn't say anything to that person. He goes, "Akhi, I can't talk to them. Who am I?" This is al-bukhlu fi badli nushi. If you see a person doing evil, our Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam instructed us that we go and we tell the person in a very well-mannered way that what they are doing is wrong. The Prophet said, "Man ra'a minkum munkaran falyughayyirhu biyadi, fa'in lam yastati' fa bilisani, fa'in lam yastati' fa biqalbi, wa dhalika adhafu al-iman." If you see evil taking place, go out and advise the person. Tell them what they are doing is wrong. But remember to watch the way you speak, your tone of voice, the way that you address the person. We're instructed here. So to say that maybe it's not for me, I'm not going to do it. This is al-bukhlu fi badli nusr. Because the whole religion is built upon what? Ad-deenu nasiha. The religion is built upon a sincere advice. قلنا لمن قال لله ولكتابه ولرسوله ولأئمة المسلمين وعامتهم, as the Prophet said, that the religion is built upon sincere advice. That you sincerely advise those who are around you. You advise your family members. You advise your children. So nasiha is what our religion is built on. A poet said something very powerful. He said, ليس عار بأن يقال فقير إنما العار أن يقال بخيل. You should never feel ashamed, and you should never feel embarrassed that you are poor. The thing that's really shaming, and it's something that's really ashaming, and it's really blameworthy, is the fact that you're stingy. Being poor is a state Allah put you in, subhanahu wa ta'ala. But stinginess is a conscious decision you made. You will be held account for your actions. Now I'm going to go into the fifth madahir, the fifth phenomenon in low aspiration. And that is al-minnah wa ta'dadul ayadi. Al-minnah wa ta'dadul ayadi. What does that mean? It means stating and mentioning to the people the blessings, the favors you've done for them. Am I not the person who did this for you, Fulan? Am I not the person who was there for you that particular day? Do you remember those type of speech is called al-minna wa ta'dadu al-ayadi? There are some people, إِذَا أَعْطَى عَطِيَّةً, if they give something to someone, أو بَذَلَ النَّصِيحَةً, or they advise someone, أو قَدَّمَ مَعْرُوفًا, or they put forward a good action, or they put forward a good gesture, what do they do to that person? They remind them what they did for them. أَتْبَعَهُ بِالْمَنِّ وَالْأَذَى. They follow that good action that they did with, I was the one who did this for you. You would have not been anything without me. Look at your position today. How did you get this? Who did this for you? Don't you ever forget me. I'm expecting a favor from you in return. And every time he does that, this shows that this person has low aspiration. It's actually a quality of dunul himma. It's not a person who has high aspiration. Why? The person who has high aspiration, what they do, they're not looking at it in the dunya. Their heart is connected somewhere else. Even they don't remember that they did this for you. Minnah is a khuluqun saqit. Mentioning the favors that you've done for others is actually a evil, despicable trait to have. It is amalun mardulun. It is also a blameworthy action. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He prohibited in the Qur'an. Allah says, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, those of you who believe, لا تبطلوا صدقاتكم بالمن والأذى. Do not destroy, do not nullify, do not corrupt your sadaqah by stating the favors that you have done for others. Don't do that. It destroys the good that you did. It destroys the righteous deed that you've put forward. It destroys it. Allah is saying to the believers, don't do that. If you've done someone good, leave it there. Who did you do it for? إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا إِنَّا نَخَافُ مِنْ رَبِّنَا يَوْمًا عَبُوسًا قَمْطَرِيرًا فَوَقَاهُمُ اللَّهُ شَرَّ ذَلِكَ الْيَوْمِ وَلَقَاهُمْ نَذَرَةً وَسُرُورًا. And you did it for whose sake? Allah, right? إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ. I'm doing it for Allah. لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا. We don't want a reward from you guys. We're not doing it for you to recognize us. That's the people who have high aspiration. Like in the one who has low aspiration, when he does you a favor, he only did it for something in return. Scratch my back, I'll scratch your back. That's the type of mindset he has. His aspiration is very low. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala says, Ya alladhina amanu la tubtilu sadaqatikum bil manni wal adha. Don't destroy your sadaqah by stating the things that you've done for others. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as al-Imam Muslim narrated in his Sahih min hadithi, Abi Dharrin radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that the Prophet said, ثَلَاثَةٌ three, لَا يُكَلِّمُهُمُ اللَّهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Three types of people Allah is not going to speak to them the day of judgment. وَلَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَيْهِمْ and Allah will not look at them. وَلَا يُزَكِّيهِمْ and Allah will not purify them. وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ and for them is a severe punishment. These people, they have a severe punishment. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Abi Dharrin radiallahu ta'ala anhu mentioned, فَقَرَأَهَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ ثَلَاثَ مَرَّاتٍ. The Prophet recited this, said this three times. Abu Dharrin then said, خَابُوا وَخَسِرُوا. These people have failed. These people are doomed. These people are in a state of destruction. مَنْ هُمْ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Who are these people that Allah will not talk to the day of judgment? Allah will not look at them the day of judgment. Allah will not purify them the day of judgment. Who are these people? The Prophet said, Al-Musbilu. It is the person whose garment drags for the man below the ankles. He's got a garment and his garment is below his ankle. Allah will not look at him the day of judgment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not purify him. And Allah will not speak to them the day of judgment. Look how severe this is. You have a garment, brother? Make sure that your garment is above your ankles. You have two places it could be. It could be in the heart, it could be halfway into your shin, which is how it used to be for the Prophet ﷺ. The Prophet ﷺ said in the hadith, he said, Izarul Muslim, Izarul Mu'min, the Izar of the Mu'min, the lower garment of the believer, is nisf al-saq, is half the shin. That's sunnah. And it's a virtuous one to do. But what you must, if you don't want that, what is obligatory on you, oh brother, is that you make sure that your garment is above your ankles. That is what? Above your ankle. That is a must for every single man, whether you're wearing trousers, whether you're wearing thobe, whether you're wearing izar, whatever you're wearing. No man's garment could drag. If you do that, Allah will not speak to you the day of judgment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not look at you. And Allah will not purify you the day of judgment. If you're willing to go through that the day of judgment and you have the strength and the ability for it, then go ahead, do it. Drag your garment. But if you know, as a believer should, that you don't have the strength to not be punished, you don't have the strength to go through adab, you can't endure Allah not speaking to you subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah not purifying you that day, then have your garment above your ankles. It's even better for your garment, brother. It's actually better for your garment. It will last longer. You don't have to go out there and get a new thobe or a new trousers. The second one is wal-mannan. The mannan is the one who mentions the favors he does for others. Oh, I am the person who did this for you. I bestowed this favor onto you. If it wasn't for me, you would have been doomed. Allah brought me for you. Akhi, I'm expecting something in return. Akhi, do you remember me? I'm the brother who did this for you. And all of these are suwar, forms in which the al-man comes about. Ali, a believer does not keep a record of that. He just waits for the reward, yawm al-qiyamah. He does it with ikhlas and sincerity, and he begs Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for acceptance, and he doesn't mention a favor he does for the believer. He doesn't. The third one is, وَالْمُنْفِقُ سِلْعَتَهُ بِالْحَلِفِ الْكَاذِبِ. The one who tries to sell his merchant with false promises. He sells his merchant and his products by swearing. Whenever you say, Akhi, is this real? Wallahi, billahi, tallahi, it's original. I bought it. And it's a lie. He knows it's a lie. And that's something that is prevalent. It's become common. People try to sell their merchants. Garage owners, they do that. Restaurants, some of them will do that to you. وَمَا إِلَى ذَلِكَ. Buying and selling, a lot of the people, they do not fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in it. They should remember that they fall under this severe warning that Allah will not talk to them yawm al-qiyamah. Allah will not look at them the day of judgment. Allah will not purify the day of judgment. And again, look what the hadith says, وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. For them is a severe punishment. A man once upon a time said to his son, قَالَ رَجُّلُ لِبَنِيهِ. A man said to his children, his sons, he said to them and his daughters, إِذَا اتَّخَدْتُمْ عِنْدَ رَجُّلٍ يَدًا فَانْسَوْهَا. If you have bestowed a good onto someone, you did something good for someone, a good gesture, فَانْسَوْهَا, forget it. Don't remember what you did. When you've done good for someone, don't remember it. وَقَالُوا, it was also mentioned, الْمِنَّةُ تَهْدِمُ الصَّنِيَعَ. Mentioning the favors you've done for others destroys the good that you did. The good that you came with, it's gone now. You destroyed it by mentioning the good that you did. Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhumah, he said, لَا يَتِيمُ الْمَعْرُوفُ إِلَّا بِثَلَاثِ. Good will not become complete. A good cannot become complete unless with three. The first one is بِتَعْجِيلِهِ, by hastening it. وَتَصْغِيرِهِ, and belittling it. وَسَتْرِهِ, and concealing it. When you are going to do something good, hasten it. Don't say, you know, I'll do this favor for you, but give me a couple of... No, hasten it. It's good. That's how it should be. Hasten in doing the good. The second one is, look at what you do to be very little. Belittle it. Say, what is that? I didn't do nothing. You see, one of the great qualities that you tend to find in many cultures, that when they look after their guests, there's a very good example I see within the culture, Somali culture, for example. What they do is that when they invite a guest over and they cook the best of what they could do, they put the best dish on the table, okay? They've exerted all their efforts. مَعَ ذَلِكَ, they see it to be very little. So they say to the guests, for example, all this food and everything I've put on the table for you is only just made your fingers dirty. You know, I haven't really done anything for you. I haven't given you food. All I've done is made your finger and your mouth dirty. This is وَتَصْغِيرِهِ, you're belittling the good that you did. The third one is وَسَتْرِهِ, to conceal it. The person doesn't show it to everybody. They look for an opportunity when the other people are not around, and he says, "Akhi, this is yours. This is yours. Keep it secret." وَسَتْرِهِ. When you do that, the good has become complete for you. A poet, he said, "أَفْسَدْتَ بِالْمَنِّ مَا أَسْتَيْتَ مِنْ حَسَنٍ لَيْسَ الْكَرِيمُ إِذَا أَسْتَى بِمَنَّانِ." He said, "أَفْسَدْتَ, you destroyed بِالْمَنِّ مَا أَسْتَيْتَ مِنْ حَسَنٍ. All the good that you did and you spent, what did you do? You destroyed it by mentioning the favors that you've done. لَيْسَ الْكَرِيمُ, the honorable one, the generous one, the one who has high aspiration. إِذَا أَسْتَى بِمَنَّانِ, he is not one that when he gives, he mentions the favor. That's not a quality known by a kareem, a generous person. A generous person is not known for that. An honorable person doesn't do those type of things. He doesn't do that. Those traits are for people who have low aspiration. With that being said, mentioning the favors you've done for others in two situations, they are all right. In two situations. And Ibn Hazm rahimahullah mentioned that. He said, حَالَانِ يَحْسُنُ فِيهِمَا مَا يَقْبَحُ فِي غَيْرِهِمَا. He said, in two situations, something that is not good in other places becomes all right, fine, in two situations. That is referring to mentioning the favors you've done. وَهُمَا الْمُعَاتَبَةِ. When you're scolding, وَالْإِعْتِذَارَ. And when you're given an excuse. فَإِنَّوْ يَحْسُنُ فِيهِمَا تَعْدِيدَ الْأَيَادِ. He said, at times like that, it's good to mention the favor you've done. وَذِكْرُ الْإِحْسَانِ. And mentioning the good gesture that you came with. He said, وَذَلِكَ غَايَةُ الْقُبْحِ فِيمَا عَدَى هَاتَيْنِ الْحَالَتَيْنِ. And if it's not in those two situations, then it's evil thing to do. And we know the Prophet وسلم, when a group of Ansar said that when the Prophet was given the spoils of war, some from the Ansar, they said that it's not fair that Muhammad gives to the Muhajirin. By the way, the Prophet ﷺ, the spoils of war, all of it he gave to the Muhajirin. He didn't give anything to the Ansar. A group of Ansar, they said, this is not fair. Our swords were, we fought and today we get nothing in return. So the Prophet ﷺ, when he heard that, he went to Ansar. He said, did you guys say that? They said, Ya Rasulullah, this has not come from our wise ones. And it didn't come from our mature senior ones. This is the statement of our youngsters. Then the Messenger gave a sermon, a khutbah for them. And he said to them, أَلَمْ أَجِدْكُمْ ضُلَّالًا فَهَدَاكُمُ اللَّهُ بِهِ. Did I not find you guys misguided? And Allah guided you guys all through me. Were you not all misguided? And Allah guided you all through me. And then he said, Allah wa Rasuluhu, Amin. Allah and His Messenger. And He's Allah and His Messenger have bestowed blessings and good on us. Then the Prophet ﷺ responded back to them and he said, why don't you guys say to me, did we not find you in need and we took you in and we took care of you, Muhammad? Why don't you say that to me? The Prophet said. And to Ansar. The point here is that وَقْتِ الْمُعَاتَبَةِ وَالْإِعْتِذَارِ. At times, even when you're giving excuses and you're asking for forgiveness, you can mention it. You can say, Akhi, I didn't really do it like that. This is what I did. At times like that, where you're not trying to you're not trying to get away with the person, or you're not trying to make the person feel like he's your captive. More times like that, Ibn Hazm is saying that it's fine to do so. We're going to stop there, inshallah ta'ala, for today's session, bi'idhnillah al-kareem. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, and shaytan and Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdi, ashadu wa la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.